The film opened in a dimly lit skating rink where Sebastian and his daughter Anna gracefully glided across the floor. Europe had fallen prey to an apocalyptic catastrophe, leaving only a small group of survivors behind a mysterious force capable of manipulating individuals through their negative emotions and driving them to suicide, had taken hold of the world. Sebastian's wife tragically became a victim of the mass suicides determined to protect Anna. He sought refuge within the rink. However, a group of blind intruders attacked Sebastian, intending to steal their food and supplies. After the attackers left, Sebastian and Anna, wearing blindfolds, ventured outside into the sunlight on their journey. Sebastian encountered a band of fellow survivors and expressed his desire to join them. However, they harbored suspicions about his intentions and potential threat to their safety. Deceptively, Sebastian portrayed himself as a former construction engineer, claiming he could provide light and indoor heating, using a generator, exploiting their trust. Sebastian secured a place in the group among them. He formed a connection with Liliana, a doctor who tended to his injuries. He also discovered an individual with self-inflicted stitches over their eyes, revealing the existence of seers, those unaffected by the malevolent entity, capable of roaming freely without blindfolds. However, the seers targeted and killed those who were vulnerable, seeking to dominate the world, maintaining a low profile. Sebastian grew concerned when Anna mysteriously disappeared, suggesting that he had lost his daughter to the insidious creature. Her spectral presence became his sole focus. The next morning, with everyone asleep inside the bus, Sebastian saw an opportunity. He locked the driver's compartment and started the engine, despite Liliana's attempts to stop him bursting forth from the shelter. Sebastian drove recklessly, causing a devastating accident. The impact left everyone injured, with none of them wearing blindfolds amidst the chaos. Sebastian once again encountered the apparition of his daughter, who commanded him to guide the injured individuals to open their eyes and face the creature following Anna's instructions. Sebastian led them to open their eyes one by one, exposing them to the blinding light emitted by the unseen entity. After witnessing the entity, an alien never shown on screen, each person began to take their own life unbeknownst to the others. Sebastian himself was a seer, deluded into believing that the entity was a divine being, saving humanity through death. His delusions were so profound that he perceived the dying victims transforming into angelic light, ascending to heaven as they succumbed to their demise in a haunting flashback to 9 months earlier. Barcelona fell under the grip of an unknown and unseen entity, driving its terrified residents to flee for their lives. Among the desperate escapees, Sebastian found himself trapped in a maelstrom of chaos, while his wife desperately warned him of the impending danger that threatened their daughter Anna. Reacting swiftly, Sebastian retrieved Anna from her school, but tragedy struck when his wife lost her life in a devastating accident, seeking solace and safety. Sebastian sought refuge in a church where he encountered Esteban, the pastor. Esteban held the belief that the entity was an angel, its divine presence rendering it impossible for people to gaze upon it in order to alleviate further suffering. Esteban proposed that humanity should be liberated from the confines of life itself. This notion deeply affected Sebastian, even as he harbored concerns for his daughter's well-being. Amidst the escalating deaths concealing themselves, Sebastian and Anna sought shelter in a secluded location, desperately grasping for moments of happiness in the midst of turmoil. However, their fragile peace was short-lived. One fateful day, a group of seers led by the pastor stumbled upon their hiding place, taking Sebastian and Anna captive. Due to Sebastian's own abilities as a seer, he did not become their target. Tragically, the pastor callously forced Anna to open her eyes, leading to her untimely demise by suicide. Overwhelmed by heartbreak, Sebastian found himself haunted by Anna's apparition. Seemingly grasping his hand unbeknownst to Sebastian, this apparition was another form of manipulation created by the entity. Fate intervened when Sebastian encountered another group of survivors led by Rafa, accompanied by his loyal dogs. The group consisted of Octavio, a delivery guy with a background in physics, Roberto, and Isabel, a couple, Claire, an English psychiatrist, and Sophia, a young German girl who had become separated from her mother during their journey to Barcelona. Despite initial reservations, Rafa allowed Sebastian to join their ranks, albeit with lingering suspicions about his true nature within the group. Sebastian, discovered solace in Sophia, who reminded him of Anna utilizing his multilingual skills. He conversed with Sophia in German, learning about her painful separation from her mother. Sophia mentioned hearing about a mountain castle believed to be the safest refuge from the entity. Sketching a picture of the castle in a cable car leading to it, Isabel deduced that Sophia was referring to Mondrik. The group agreed to embark on a perilous journey towards Mondrik. As they ventured through the city, they once again confronted the entity, which assumed the form of their deceased loved ones. These apparitions served as painful distractions, and Rafa tragically lost his life as a result. Taking shelter in a dark refuge, Octavio shared his belief that the entity was a quantum being, existing within a fluctuating compound and capable of perceiving human emotions, particularly fear and grief, during their time in the shelter. Sebastian's susceptibility to Anna's manipulative influence led him to open a window, resulting in Octavio's demise. At this critical juncture, Sebastian's faith in his beliefs and the morality of his actions began to waver. He could no longer perceive the light emanating from Octavio's body, as doubt began to overshadow his convictions with Roberto, Isabel, Claire, Sophia, and Sebastian. As the sole survivors, they pressed onward towards Montauk, relentlessly pursued by the group of seers. Roberto and Isabel tragically lost their lives, but Sebastian managed to guide Claire and Sophia to a safe zone. During this time, Claire started suspecting Sebastian's true nature as one of the seers, prompting her to shield Sophia from him, however. As Anna's relentless urgings to remove Sophia's blindfold weighed heavily on Sebastian, he finally drew a line. He came to the realization that his actions were wrong and that he was not genuinely helping people by leading them to their deaths. Resisting Anna's influence, Sebastian convinced Sophia and Claire that he meant them no harm, vowing to protect them at all costs, while Sophia and Claire placed their trust in Sebastian. Once again, their hideout came under a relentless attack by the pastor and his followers, leading Sophia and Claire to safety. Sebastian encountered and successfully eliminated an assailant. They managed to escape in a car, making a beeline for Mondrik. But Esteban and his followers persisted in their pursuit. Upon reaching the tower, Sebastian urged Claire to take Sophia and proceed while he held off Esteban. In a fierce confrontation, Sebastian managed to prevent Esteban from entering. Meanwhile, Claire led Sophia up a treacherous flight of stairs to the control room inside. They discovered that the cable cars were not operational. Thinking on her feet, Claire devised a clever plan. She rang a large bell, creating vibrations that attracted the entity towards them. As the entity approached, the environment around them began to tremble, including the cable cars, desperate to entice Claire and Sophia. The entity mimicked the voices of their loved ones. Nevertheless, Claire and Sophia remained resolute and boarded one of the cable cars, safely making their way to the mountain castle back at the tower. Sebastian engaged in a violent confrontation with Esteban, injuring him with an iron rod. However, Sebastian himself sustained injuries. During the intense struggle, both men succumbed to their wounds. But Sebastian found solace in knowing that he had successfully guided Claire and Sophia to safety before taking his final breath upon reaching the castle. Sophia joyfully reunited with her mother. Meanwhile, Claire was escorted to a laboratory where she underwent blood tests. Curious about the purpose of the tests, Claire questioned the other researchers. One of them explained that they were attempting to identify a chemical indicator, an epigenetic alteration that would pinpoint the effects of trauma and precisely determine the emotions targeted by the entity. Their ultimate goal was to develop an antibody that would provide immunity against the entity's influence. In the concluding scene of the movie, the researchers were depicted administering the epigenetic antibody to rats and placing their cages within a secure containment room. Concurrently, a seer, seemingly one of the experimental subjects, lay in bed observing the proceedings. Suddenly, an ominous growl emanated from the containment room, prompting the seer's urgent request to witness what was unfolding.